Hey, good morning. Tim Sykes here doing a quick video lesson. I want to get this out before my trading challenge webinar. Challenge students 4 to 6 p.m. today. Come with questions. Hopefully you watch this video beforehand so that we can be prepared. MDMP spiking like a freaking crazy play. Supernova, former runner. I banked on it last time. I remember buying this, what, at like 7 cents, 20 cents. I mean, this thing just keeps going. It's just unbelievable. Went all the way up to a dollar, now came all the way back down. Today, press release saying they closed on the acquisition. StocksToTrade Breaking News. I don't know how many times I have to say use it every single day. Some people are like, how did you spot the news so quickly? I will link StocksToTrade Breaking News. It is the height of all laziness, stupidity, narrow-mindedness, incompetence not to use it. There is no other service on the entire internet specifically designed for low-priced breaking news. It's curated news. It's not just a news wire. So you can scan thousands of news wires and you won't know which news actually matters. StocksToTrade Breaking News nailed it right here. I got the alert when it was around 18 cents. I didn't get it right at the beginning, but I did bank on it. This was my profit, by the way, and I sold way too soon too. I got it in the low 20s, out in the mid 20s. Right now, mid 30s. So even though, you know, I made a few thousand dollars on it, literally could have been double or triple this amount. So in case you ever wonder, what is the potential? What is the upside for breaking news? Why do I even bother with breaking news? I know it's speculative. This is exactly why. Former runner, breaking news. I totally nailed it, but I also totally underestimated it. I really don't know what to say. I make so many video lessons. So many people are like, I just don't know if I should use StocksToTrade. Use it. Okay. Yes. I'm an investor in StocksToTrade. Yes. I know the two traders who run it. I know they're very hardworking. I love them to death. So I'm biased. Say whatever you want, but use the damn breaking news service. Look at it. It just keeps going now. 34s. Even if I had got, the dip, I was trying to, I nailed the initial spike, but I was trying to get the dip. I thought that it was going to come down back to 20 or 21. Only came down really to like 23. I know it says it got down to 22, but that's just a typo. It really hung around in the 23s. Best case scenario for me, had I got my rebuy opportunity in the 23s, I would have sold it, you know, 31-ish. I probably would have even sold half here at 29. I would have made another 6 cents. But this thing just keeps going. I don't know how high it goes. Congrats to everyone. You know, I mean, this is madness. I literally banked, you know, I'm up nearly 10K on the day, my best day of the week so far. You know, we've had a little bit of a slower market and I just totally underestimated the play of the day. And I hope you see that. Like, it's not that I'm such a great trader. It's not that like, I know everything. It's that I use the right tools. I have the right mindset. And there's just frankly a lot of opportunity. I totally missed HENC today. You know, this was a big runner. I missed this dip buy. I was running around too crazy with too many plays. Beautiful dip buy opportunity here. You know, I don't mind missing this spike because we just haven't seen that many initial morning spikes lately on plays like this. But this dip off of 20 down to 14, sell it anywhere here in the 16s, 17s, 18s. I probably would have gotten faked out here at 20, but this is a 50%, you know, bounce. What I did nail aside from MDMP, I made some money on DPSM, LTNC, JZZI. JZZI, by the way, former runner that did not keep going. So if you ever ask like, Tim, why don't you just buy and like hold these plays? They oftentimes go further. Sometimes they don't. I would have liked to, not necessarily, I don't mind selling, you know, MDMP on my first sell. But I would have liked to dip by that drop and then capture the second move. JZZI, I went for the morning spike. They had news. If you remember, it was just a few weeks ago where they really went supernova. So I'll try these plays for giant supernovas, but there is a reason why I sell. Just in case, you know, JZZI, I had a nice profit here and you know what, this thing is now 50% lower than where I sold it. So you can't count on all of them going MDMP style. So in case you ever wonder, like, don't or I wouldn't, I mean, you can do whatever you want, but I wouldn't personally just hold and hope on any of these plays. I don't mind selling a little too quickly on MDMP. Like I said, I missed really the dip buy. That was the one that I regret. JZZI, I sold near the highs. LTNC, I also underestimated. Today is a day of underestimating, but I want you to leave a comment saying it's okay to underestimate. Like I've locked in nearly 10K and I've underestimated nearly every stock that I've traded. LTNC, big runner, the best, multi-day runner that I see. Congrats to the whole LTNC army. Every other promo should get inspired by LTNC and see what they've done, where they've like unified everybody on Twitter. And it's like literally they have like their own hashtag LTNC army. The good news is it creates predictable patterns. It's gone up further than I thought. And now, frankly, it's bounced better than I thought that it would. Remember, this was a sub penny stock, so I'm just overly cautious. Again, leave a comment underneath this video saying it's okay to be overly cautious because I nailed the bottom here. I wasn't tempted here, really, maybe a little tempted, but this actually turned out to be a fake out. I was a little busy with CWRK, but even if I had bought it would have only been a small position. I nailed the bottom here with size. On LTNC, okay, I nailed the absolute bottom, and I was really happy with this, even though it doesn't look like much. This was one of my better trades of the week. Morning panics haven't been ideal lately, so I nailed this. I nailed this run up from 6.4 to 6.7 ish. It doesn't look like much here because it went up to 7.2, so. I took like a third of the potential profits, but then it also came down again, and I wasn't sure whether to dip buy it here. Some people say, like, why don't you dip buy the double bottom? Like, now we see that it's a double bottom, but I'm not going to be aggressive on this play because, frankly, I'm scared of it. I'm not going to be aggressive on dip buys because, frankly, dip buys haven't been that great lately. So this was a good, playing it overly cautious. And I want you to learn to spot the difference, okay? LTNC, dip buy is not in favor, kind of a sketchy, questionable stock. JZZI, former supernova, I bought the morning spike. It didn't play out, so I just exited for a small profit. I stayed cautious. Both of these, you got to stay cautious on. And then MDMP, again, I really nailed it. This is my, best play of the day, but I missed the second dip buy. Also, right at the open, this is what kind of screwed me up. You got to be careful with the stocks that you choose right at the open. CWRK had this deal with YVR, former multi-day runner, former supernova, but very choppy. And holding this support right here, at this line at like 220-ish. So I thought, wow, like news, this should spike right away. And we haven't seen a right away spike. I was in here in this choppiness in the 230s. And frankly, when you buy a stock near the market open, you got to choose really carefully because it's not just about the money. Like it takes time, right? Like you only have so much, you only have so much mental capital. You only have so much space in your head, on your computer. Remember, for me, near the market open, it's a little more difficult than what you have to do because I'm typing out alerts and I want people to never follow alerts, but to learn in real time and see my plan. So when there's plays near the market open, like I better be sure that it's going to be a good play. Otherwise, even if it's not, like I was profitable on CWRK, I was dead on right as it turned out that it was going to be a big spiker, but it didn't spike fast enough and it took my time away from other plays. I can't go back in time, but maybe I would have seen HENC on this morning spike, and maybe I would have caught the dip. So this, little profit actually cost me time, it cost me money, it cost missed opportunity. So I just exited. And now you say, like, wow, it's in the 270s. You didn't have to exit. You turned out to be right. But I wasn't right, when I thought that I would. It wasn't a quick morning spiker. It's more of a gradual play, and I just don't have time. I mean, I've already done what, half a dozen trades today. One, let me see, one, two, three, four, five. Has it only really been five trades? No, come on. Oh, GTII also. I forgot about that. I'm like, wait a minute, what's going on? One, two, three, four, five, six trades. Okay. GTII, by the way, was another morning panic play. And this one didn't panic perfectly or bounce perfectly. It actually had like a delayed panic right in here in the 180s after a crack too. And now look at it. I mean, now this is insane. This is a 50% bounce. So it looks like another one that I underestimated. But choppy panics haven't been working that well. So you can look at these trades and say, dead on right, GTII 50% bounce, dead on right, CWRK, massive spike. JZZI was the only one that I traded cautiously, and I was right to trade cautiously because I caught the top. LTNC, way too cautious. DPSM, I didn't even see what DPSM did afterwards. DPSM, had the breaking news spike and then failed. So I caught that one. And then MDMP, I underestimated. So out of these six stocks, JZZI and DPSM, I profited roughly 1,000 on each, but I caught, the meat of the move because I traded it cautiously. GTII, too early, but choppy play. Dip buys haven't been great. Massive underestimation. Now I guess I should look at a little later in the morning for dip buys. CWRK again, morning spike, but very gradual. Might have to look a little later. And then LTNC, I underestimated. MDMP, I missed the dip buy on the second dip buy or the second trade, which was a dip buy opportunity right in here after a drop from 26 down to 23. So that's how I start to judge different trades, right? Like four out of the six, I underestimated. I traded cautiously on all of them. That's just what I do. Again, leave a comment underneath this video if you understand that's why I trade cautiously. Like I'm underestimating the majority of the plays and I'm still making nearly 10 grand on the day. And understand, I'm not trading that with that much size. Some people are like, "Oh, 10 grand is amazing, but you're trading with big size." No, I'm not. I'm taking 5, 10, 15, 20,000, $30,000 positions. I know that might seem like a lot to you guys, but like I've been doing this 20 plus years, okay? Other people have been doing this for 15, 20 plus years. I mean, they're taking hundreds of thousands of dollars and millions of dollars in positions. And yes, that makes it, choppier and I don't think that you can capture the meat of the move. I actually like trading with small size, but understand that to make 10 grand, like I'm not using millions of dollars, okay? I want to be very clear with that. So look at my position sizes on these plays. And I'm getting like partial fills here or there. These stocks move fast. It's not an exact science. What I want you to understand is how I take the meat of the move, how I trade so cautiously, and when I screw up or when I miss out on an opportunity, I want to talk about it. That's why I led with MDMP. I wasn't like, look at me, I nailed this play. I was like, look at me, I did well. Everyone should use StocksToTrade Breaking News. It's absurd that more people don't. But I missed the bigger opportunity on the second spike. And therein lies my mistake, because this could have been a 15, maybe $20,000 day for me. Every day is different, right? Like some people say, like, oh, the market's slow this week, I'm just not gonna trade. I think that's a mistake. Every single day can open up new opportunities. Yes, it's been a slow week, but we know that, which I don't think is a good idea, but we know that people are putting their stimulus checks into their brokerage accounts. So we're having stimulus check funded volatility. So every single day, I think there's going to be opportunities. Some days might be slower than others. There's a lot of people who are spoiled. I'm getting messages from people like I made from January and February where they make 10, 20, 30 grand in a day, some of my students. And now they're like, what happened? What am I doing wrong? I've lost 1,000. Like they're so spoiled. They think the market just exists to give them $10,000, $20,000, $30,000 a day. That's the wrong perspective. I'm so proud to remind everybody that 90% plus of traders lose. And yet, there is opportunity if you know where to look. I should highlight one tweet that I saw. One second, let me find this. Here's one tweet from one of my students, and he said, LTNC morning panic dip buy, CWRK former runner, HENC multi-day breakout. And this is, what you kind of have to think about. Like, you choose what patterns you're best at, whether you like morning panic dip buys whether you like former runners with news. You know, this was before MDMP. Like I said, do you want a video lesson? And this was literally like just before MDMP, former runner with news. But MDMP is the same thing as HENC. They're both former supernovas, okay? So if you ever start to wonder like how these stocks move, they move with very similar patterns. HENC once upon a time was a former runner back here. Like today is obviously like a bigger run. But if you go back in time, like, you know, it's had several spikes. Former runners can spike again. MDMP was a gigantic supernova. And again, in hindsight, you know, maybe I should have given it more time. You know, this dip buy was very quick. It's not a total surprise that I missed it because I thought that it would drop lower. But at the same time, like I'm trading cautiously and I'm adapting to the market. I probably should have been more aggressive on LTNC out of anything, because that was, you know, we know that that's like the most heavily promoted name right now. That's the best multi-day runner. That's usually going to have the biggest bounce. But morning bounces haven't been that great. So I'm constantly trying to judge, like, how hot is this stock? How hot is this pattern? How hot is the market? You know, really use the Sykes sliding scale and really use Stocks to Trade Breaking News. I'm getting messages. People are like, I don't even see any MDMP news. And I'm like, you're lost. You know, if you're not using level two, if you're not using Stocks to Trade Breaking News, if you don't have the plan, if you don't know these patterns, like, you're just going to be lost. These stocks move fast enough as it is. I'm missing plays. I'm missing, you know, a lot of my executions because these things move very fast. So don't expect perfect execution. Don't expect perfect price action. Again, for a third or fourth time, leave a comment below this video saying it's good to be cautious. You know, we're trading the most volatile stocks. So I think you have to have the proper perspective. And yet, there's so much hate with these penny stocks. There's so much hate with day trading. There's so much ignorance. There's so much BS. You know, promoters will try to rip on you if you post like a small gain or small loss. They'll be like, oh, Sykes teaches you to collect just pennies when you're missing out on the majority of the run. That's rubbish, okay? Never forget, my top students all started small. Let me show you one more tweet before I go. Okay, I lied. Three more tweets and then I'm done. But I hope that, you know, you remember these lessons, because I'm dealing with constant daily like misinformation from promoters who say don't trade small, penny stocks are a scam, Sykes is a scam. Like, I'm just so sick of the misinformation. Mariana, my first female millionaire student, had this tweet from February. I love bringing it up. She traded OZSC. I'll bring it up again and again because this lesson is, you know, so important. She made $38 8 months ago, dip buying OZSC. You know, when OZSC got hot, later, more liquid, she got more confidence, and she did the exact same trade 8 months later for nearly $17,000 in profits. So if you ever have a $38 profit or anything around that size, understand that's how Mariana started too. And she was able to scale up. And it's not just her. This is Tim Grittani. You know, you might know him as the guy who made over $13 million, but if you go back to when he first began a decade ago, look at his early trades, 114, negative 8, plus 27. Like, he started trading small too. All my most successful students follow instructions. They trade small at first. They paper trade, but they learn what their favorite patterns are. They learn how to modulate in different markets. They learn to stay cautious. They learn to get aggressive later on with, you know, their favorite patterns and in the right markets. That's trading. And also, I got to congratulate Art of War in the challenge chat, Ellis. I'm giving a challenge webinar in a few hours from now, 4 to 6 p.m. So again, challenge students, come ready with questions. But Ellis, amazing student. Just made him a moderator in the challenge chat room because he helps so many students. You know, he helps me mentor. I'm so grateful to a lot of my top students for helping me mentor, because I'm like losing my mind, losing my voice a lot of the time, just trying to keep up. And Ellis, you know, fantastic guy, over 300,000 now in profits, former athlete, former NFL athlete, actually pretty amazing. And you know, I'm just looking for more dedicated students. That's what this is all about. I want you to see this volatility. I want you to see these opportunities. I want you to capitalize on them, whether you're paper trading, whether you're trading small, whether you're missing them. There's still a lot to be learned, even if you miss these plays. I saw somebody being like, oh, I'm too slow on the executions on MDMP. I've been doing this 2 decades and I missed my dip buy. Okay. So it happens. It's okay. Learn from it. Learn to be a little quicker. I'll learn from this. And that's why I make videos too, to help you learn, to help myself remember these lessons. Because it's not just about the money that you make or lose. It's how can you take the meat of the move? How can you adapt to the market? How can you figure out what works best for you? Everyone watching this video is different. So anyways, good little morning, 10K nearly on the day, trading overly cautious. Challenge students, remember, webinar later today with me and also Jack too, Jack Schwartz, my second millionaire named Jack. He's going to give a challenge webinar next Thursday, 4 to 6 p.m. Eastern. So come ready with questions for that. And, you know, this is what I love seeing. Literally, students, when they succeed, they want to help others because they know, you know, what a struggle it is. Jack Schwartz is still in school, which is crazy. Grad school, I think. And, you know, he's over a million now, too. I'll teach anybody. You just got to be dedicated. You know, Jack Schwartz DM'd me a few years ago. He's embarrassed that I shared it with everybody. So that's why I like to share it even more. He like DM'd me like sometime in the morning. He's like, I'm up early. Can you teach me? And I was like, what are you talking about? Like, get in my challenge. And he didn't even get in the challenge for like 2 more years. In 2017, I think he joined. So it's been like 4 years since Jack became a millionaire. Let me see. Let me find his thing. Hold on. This is Jack. I mean, he calls himself Jack Daniel, but his name is Jack Schwartz. I just think he just, maybe his middle name is Daniel. Maybe he likes Jack Daniel. I don't know. But year to date now, he's made 800 grand out of his 1.27 million. So, you know, understand he's been in my challenge for 4 years and he made like hardly anything the first like 3 years. Like even this difference, you know, between nearly 1.3 and 800,000. So it's like, what, like 400,000, 470,000. That was like in the last, I want to say like 3 months of 2020. Like if you look at all of his stuff, like over the past year, look at this. This is a good example. So over the past year, 1 year since last March, he's made 1.25 out of his 1.27 million. But you know, if you watch my interview with him, just like Jack Kellogg, just like Matt Monaco, just like Huddy, just like Kyle, just like Mariana, all these new millionaires, and Dom too. And I'm sorry, there's even a new one who surprised me the other day with his son, and I gotta post the video, but it's a little complicated, as you'll soon see. All of these guys and girls, they were all in the challenge for 3, 4, 5 years first. So if you're ever wondering like, oh, I'm first week, second week, third week, first month, second month, third month, fourth month, sixth month. If you're ever wondering like, why does it seem like, quote, easier for us? It does get easier over time. But the reason why is because we just have seen so many plays. And if you listen to that video that I did with Jack too, you know, he's like, I needed to learn from my mistakes. I needed to learn from that whole journey, and that helped me better prepare. And Jack has been killing it. Like, you know, it's actually pretty amazing. He has to update his thing. I think he might even be over like 1.4 million or 1.5 million now. He's had a fantastic week. He had a nice $100,000 plus day the other day. It's a journey. It's a process. So, you know, if you wonder why I'm not like editing these videos, why I might seem unprofessional, because nothing matters, right? Like I'm not professional. I don't ever want to be thought of as professional. I'm not trying to edit. I'm trying to share lessons every day. Good trades, bad trades. Yesterday, I barely even traded. I had a busy day. I made a few a few hundred bucks. Some people were like ripping on me on Twitter. Like, what? You're supposed to be a millionaire and you only made a few a few hundred bucks? Yeah. So what? Some days I get busy. Some days I'm off. Welcome to the reality of trading. It's not pretty. It's the process that matters the most. And hopefully, you know, my lack of professionalism weeds out some lazy people so I don't have to deal with your BS. It is kind of crazy being real in an industry full of fakes. I have to weed out students with bad attitudes. I have to save what little sanity I have left. Most people won't even make it to the end of this video. They're just like, give me hot picks. That's not what it's about. It's about having the right mindset, perspective, strategy, tools. Again, I'm going to link StocksToTrade Breaking News. below. Even if you're not trading, learn to see which breaking news plays move the most and the fastest so that you can be better prepared. This is a game of adaptation. And we're trading the most volatile stocks in the entire market, which the whole world thinks I'm crazy. But I'm not. I just see where opportunity is, and I hope you see it. Anyways, I got to go. Challenge students, webinar 4 to 6 p.m. with me today, and Jack 2 next week, next Thursday, and other scheduled webinars too. But this is just a special. Thanks.